Welcome back to Warthorn Weekly News. This week, I got two major news stories for you and one question. Are submarines coming to War Thunder? Hit that subscribe button, let's find out. So the first news story is about the Javelin. It got a kind of Devblog. They did what they did with the Type 90, where they went through and talked about the plane and where they got the stats and how the stats line up with the plane. And essentially, they came out saying that they had gotten their stats from flight manuals, and they showed this picture of a red and white Javelin, and Gaijin, why isn't this camo in game? Whatever. Despite the evidence they've shown, many people came claiming these were in fact wrong, and I believe posted quite a lot of counter evidence. Now, I don't know anything about the Javelin or really any Cold War aircraft, so I can't really put my input on this, on who is correct, what is right. However, the feller by the name of the Scottish Koala made an excellent video explaining all the issues with it. I'll link it into the corner and in the description below. But anyways, apparently there's also a rumor going around that they have plans to actually update the Javelin to make it not trash, and that apparently this update is going to come sometime early February. Unfortunately, I cannot find where this rumor originated. People claim it came from the form mod Pony51, although I could not find any quotes of him stating that. So that's, I'd have to say, pure speculation, unless someone can bring it up to me. The other news is about some naval data mines that happened, one on the Reddit and one from the European Canadian. What these data mines were targeting was naval stuff, and what they found is many naval guns had gotten their textures. To name a few, I could say depth charge mount type 2, type 94, torpedo 610mm type 93, which I believe are the long lance oxygen torpedoes the Japanese used that were not only extremely deadly to enemy ships, but also to their own ships. The 75mm type 88 cannon, which was, I believe, is a anti-aircraft gun. I don't know what type of ship it was on, but it was used on land. The 80mm type 88 cannon, which was on many ships, including the Kuma class light cruiser, and despite it being said to be 80mm, it's actually 76. The Japanese were kind of weird, and they labeled a lot of 76mm guns 80. I think that was to separate their ammunition from the 75s. Kind of like how the US labels recoilless rifles as 106mm guns, even though they're 105, to separate their ammo from 105mm guns that have recoil. There were some machine guns found as well. Also a turret for the 100mm Type 89 Mod A, which I believe are the guns used on the Akizuki that have a very deadly reputation. A 120mm Type 3 turret, a 127mm Type 3 Type D turret, another 127mm Type B, and 140mm 50 Type 3, which I believe are the guns that are on the Kuma-class light cruiser. After that is a multitude of many smaller type of guns, just typical Japanese anti-air guns, including the well-known 25mm, along with a twin and a triple, although it's spelled triple X, which is weird. Now, the European Canadian's data mine came to some of the same files, but he had some other ones and a interesting conclusion, which will pose a very meaty question. So the first thing he brought up was there's textures for the E-7K2 aircraft. Now, I'm pretty sure this texture is going to be a scout plane on the Kuma-class light cruiser, like how we see other scout planes on other light cruisers that unfortunately can't take off. Come on, Gaijin. You got a plane game. You got ships. Make it happen. It'll be awesome. I don't know how it'll work, but just do it. There's three flag textures of Japanese flags, a bunch of textures of lifeboats, models of Japanese sailors sitting around, a medium Japan radar model, some of the guns that we already talked about, the 75mm Type 88 and the 80 Type 88, the 610mm Type 93 torpedo, the turrets that I already talked about, but also a turret of a JM61 RFS. JM61 is a Japanese version of the M61, which is the Vulcan, the gun that is currently on that one top tier US spag. This is most likely to be on the One Go fast attack hydrofoil. And the One Go is a copy of the Italian ship by some long Italian name that has the automatic turret and armed with anti-ship missiles. This is likely to be a Japanese and Italian 4.0 to 3.7 vessel. It's a hydrofoil, apparently based off the one in the U.S. tree, if I recall correctly. After that, he had a list of torpedo turrets from what I assume various nations. If I recall correctly, they were just textures, not models. One that he brought into question was this one that was the 533 Quinari PR Mark II. Now, the data miner, seeing this texture, stated that he thought it looked like a submarine. However, when I Google search 533 PR Mark II, it brings me to two ships on World of Warships wiki page, the Darling class destroyer and the Jutland destroyer, which is a battle class. Essentially, that is the Quinari PR Mark II is a torpedo turret. That's already in game. Which points out that some of this information is kind of old. After the torpedo turret was a bunch of torpedoes, some of which he claimed were submarine torpedoes, which poses the question, is Gaijin going to be adding submarines? And he finally ended it with something that he seemed very enthusiastic about, was the Holmann Projector, which is a anti-aircraft rocket launcher for low-flying aircraft. However, that has also been in the files since at least 2016. But on those submarines, first we have to think, why would Gaijin make the jump to add submarines? Well, first of all, they've been asked for a lot, like a lot. And if I recall correctly, Wargaming is planning on putting submarines into World of Warships. If Gaijin were to add submarines before World of Warships got them, that would be quite the spicy meme, in my personal opinion. Now, is there any evidence that they are even thinking about it? Well, last year there was the April Fool's event of the nuclear submarines. But that was the April Fool's event, and I'm pretty convinced that it was actually testing air-to-air missiles, not the submarines. Although maybe they were double-dipping. However, as the European Canadian claimed, some of these torpedoes are apparently submarine-only torpedoes. And the 80mm Type 88 cannon did appear on some Japanese submarines. Although, it also appeared on the Kuma. And I think it's pretty evident that we're going to get the Kuma as the Japanese light cruiser, which might be a bit of a disappointment because it only has 140mm guns. And I think it only had like 60mm of armor. Maybe Gaijin will do something nice and surprise us with a second, more aggressive Japanese light cruiser, like the Agano, which really I just want another ship with turrets and one that doesn't explode if an AT shell bugs it in the wrong way like the Russian one does. But anyways, submarines. You think we're gonna get them? I'm not so sure. Tell me what you think down below. In other news, on the shooting range, a question was asked, can we get Japanese boats, the BT-24, the Skink, Bob Simple, Tog 2, AMX-40, and Fixed Javelin? And the reply was, Japanese boats are in progress. BT-42, no plans. Skink and Tog 2 can't deny or confirm anything, which really hints or something. Bob Simple, highly unlikely, which is a big miss on Gaijin's part. AMX-40, already in game, why did you even ask for that? Javelin, we're working on it. And check out the forum post, which links to the forum post I talked about earlier in this video. And then someone asked about Italian supersonic jets, and they're like, we got plans for that, everyone. The Russian shooting range people asked for Czech vehicles, gun barrel collision, napalm and nuclear weapons, being able to hear the sonic boom, and removing water from one of the cap zones of Vietnam, and Gaijin was like, nope. Personally, I think I'd be a bit in favor of gun barrel collision, because that'd be kind of cool. Well, it would be bring a whole lot of different stuff to the game, and gun barrels like going through enemy tanks and whatnot, so it's kind of bug me, but it could be annoying in other ways. And Gaijin, we need nuclear winter now. Anyways, remember last week when I brought up that the background to the main page of War Thunder website changed, you changed the language to Russian? Well, strangely enough, they changed the background again to this very cool Vietnam-esque one with Hueys flying over a jungle, and it doesn't change if you change the language to Russian. So, I don't know. Maybe guys are just trying to keep me down. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, hit the like button. If you didn't like the video, don't really hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit that subscribe button. I make these news videos every weekend. I make random videos throughout the weekend. I make live streams on Friday. So hit that bell icon to be notified if I upload anything. Join my Discord if you want to chill like a villain. Thanks for watching. I hope you have a great day.